2003 Ford Focus ZX3 SVT. The official car of I Go to Villanova.
I'm not crazy, I'm just a little Euro right now. Seems like you don't know. But drive a while and maybe then you'll see a different ZX3.
The ZX3 SVT is the North American version of the Focus ST at the time. We didn't get the real ST until just recently. The full designation of this yellow car is 2003 Ford Focus ZX3 SVT EAP. You understand this part, but after that comes a lot of designations. ZX3 tells you two things. Z says that the engine is Ford's ZTEC plant. X3 tells you how many doors the car has, and rear hatches are considered doors these days. SVT stands for Special Vehicles Team, and EAP stands for European Appearance Package. 2003 was not a stable year for Pennsylvania or any other state. Our governor at the time, Ed Randell, would blast his motorcade at 100 miles per hour on the turnpike between Harrisburg and Philadelphia. If you wanted to upload a video in 2003, you had to know someone with server space. You also needed to know how to use an FTP client. Nothing too crazy, just a drag and a drop thing, but there was some basic HTML to know. Dreamweaver, Microsoft FrontPage. Anyway, the SVT ZTEC was America's answer to Honda's VTEC, a Yankee charge for our own moonshot to naturally aspirated high comp nirvana.
And we won.
For this short time, Ford beat Honda at their NA game in 2003. The ZX3 SVT made 170 horsepower, 10 more than the Civic Si's 160. The engine's power comes on so stealthily it takes you by surprise, like getting ambushed with a birthday song at Red Lobster. Right, what's up with this black Focus? Understand that when a car is good, it's faked. Cloned. You know, do up a base model so at a glance it looks like a higher trim. Any good car is cloned. Buick Regals made to look like Grand Nationals. Base neons swapped with hoods and grills to mimic an SRT4. And horrific misuse of VTEC stickers. Why should anything be so different here? If men are willing to turn Pontiac Fieros into Ferraris, what's to stop a few wheel swaps on a Focus? But the Special Vehicles team did more than one-up Honda. They buried the 1990s and any notion that all you needed to do to seduce the youth was battery draining amplifiers and neon lights. You needed tight springs, arresting hook brakes, Recaro seats, and enough gears to make sure you're constantly steering with one hand. You know, your forearm cantilevered over the steering wheel to 12 o'clock position, veins visible as you give your best knowing Vin Diesel glance to that Civic driver telegraphing his inevitable loss of everything he holds dear in his 20-year-old life. After all, it was all going to pieces, wasn't it? John Kerry was the Democrats' best hope, a drooping face, long-winded bore. We, the vast Petco parking lot of 20-nothings, were out on our own in a way we never were before. The future was unknown in those days, and the only thing we knew for sure that wasn't a lie was an endless Middle East meat grinder, and we knew we were headed there. And why not? Going to war meant 3 square meals and a cot, and a better wage than retail, provided you make it out alive with most of your sanity intact. Sad times. Dark times. But even in those dark times, there was this. The ZX3 SVT. It was more than a peppy hatchback. It was that winking candle of American exceptionalism still not extinguished. It's the official car of breaking out on your own and welcoming the uncertainty with the same nervous joy of senior skip day. Driving this car gives you back that teenage feeling that you're getting away with something naughty.
I'm not crazy, I'm just a little Euro right now. Seems like you don't know. But drive a while and maybe then you'll see a different ZX3. All my front and rear lights are HID, but please try not to judge me. My ZTEC makes it an SVT and trim is the EAP.
Not saying that in front of those kids. So this guy just came up in this yellow car with a GoPro on his head, yelled, "My dick did this," and then ran away.